My name is Corinne and this is podcast Creanelia number 26. Today is the 16th of April and it is Tuesday. I come to you from the Netherlands, so that makes me Dutch, and I do apologize for any silly mistakes I make. English is not my mother tongue. As I said, it's Tuesday today. It's in the afternoon already. This morning I had a dentist appointment, so I couldn't film this morning. And they had great news because in 2 weeks I have to go back to the dentist to remove some fillings and replace them. I'm not looking forward to that at all, but it is what it is. You want to have good teeth, right? It's raining at the moment. I don't know if you can hear it because we have, how do you call that? Not crooked, is it crooked windows? Well, we have windows that are like this. And when it rains, it's very noisy. But we had weird weather. Yesterday, it was awful. Well, awful. I like storm, but last night we had thunder and lightning, and it was so loud. It was straight above our house. And today we have sunshine and then rain and then sunshine and rain. And I think it's all over Europe like this, but not much you can do about it. Perfect weather for knitting and crocheting. Right, I have a couple of things to show you. I have finished one thing, and in my last podcast I mentioned an item that I was working on, and I will show that to you today because I didn't do that last time. Oh, and I have a bit of a vlog at the end. It was Saturday a week ago. My boyfriend and I went out for the day with his work, which was from the company where he works for. We went to Den Bosch, or 's-Hertogenbosch, the official name. Very old city, and I filmed some footage, and if you like to see some old Dutch cities, then do watch, and if you don't want to see that, just skip it. But I will put it on the end of this video, so then you can make up your mind. And I will tell you at the end of this video also a bit about that city and what we did over there. Right, I finished one thing, as I said. It's a hat. This is a very simple hat. The pattern is by Pearl Soho and a bit of myself. I just made it up as I went. I knitted the brim was knit 5, purl 2. I think it was, yeah. And then I turned the hat, made a double stitch, like a short row, because if you don't do that, then this will get to the front of the hat instead of this part, and I wanted this side of the brim on the front. Then I decreased, a very simple way. I think it's on my Ravelry page, also called Creanelia. I put some notes on there. The yarn I used was a gift years ago by the company Signet Yarns. I used to sell their yarns, and this is Signet Chunky Utopia in the color, I don't know, I don't remember, sorry. It's a bit pink, lots of pink. And yeah, I think it's just a fun hat for as a gift. I'll give it away because I don't have a face for hats, not hats like this. And this is more like a beanie, because I made it a bit longer. This is 100% acrylic, so it won't be that warm, but I think it's warm enough. Because even if it's acrylic, if you put something on your head, it's warm. So this is the only thing I finished. I will make another one, because I also have this yarn in blue. And yeah, I'll make another hat, and it will be for my gift box, I think. At Christmas I will put the box under the Christmas tree for my family, and if they want something, then they can pick anything they like. I also want to make a pair of socks for that box. So, a simple hat. And these projects are ideal for car knitting or waiting at the dentist. This morning when I was waiting in the dentist waiting room, I had an appointment at 10 and it was my turn at 20 past 10, so I thought, I should have brought my knitting. I thought, who cares if I knit here? All the other people just watch their phones. I thought, I should have brought my knitting. What a waste of time. So, yeah, very quick project and highly recommend this. So, Pearl Soho has a couple of free patterns on their website. My hat. What am I wearing? I am wearing the No Frill sweater, a pattern by Petite Knit. And I really love this sweater. I like the neckline. It's not itchy at all. It's not doing this. This I don't like, but this is fine. And I always wear a t-shirt under this with long sleeves. What I really would like if the shirt was like this, that you can see the white edging, but the shirt is rather deep, I think. But this is fine, and I like the sleeves, they're long, and I love the fabric. It's a mixture of two strands, Scheepjes Alpaca Rhythm in the color Robotic, and Rowan Felted Tweed in the color Frozen. And I don't know for sure if that color is still available, but I really love this sweater. I've used this yarn before for the Southwood sweater, then I frogged the whole sweater and made the no frills. I love this pattern, and I love it so much that I am currently working on a second no frills sweater, but with a twist. I'll show you the yarns first. I forgot to show the pattern in my Dutch video, I think. But this is the no frills. Yeah, so very simple, with a raglan sleeve, and I like raglan. What am I doing at the moment? First the yarn. I'm knitting this with Ulrika by Yerbo. Zwarte Faret. My Swedish is not very good. And this is the main color, green. This is called Moss, I think. And this is 100% wool, non-superwash. It's very rustic, but it's not itchy. If you know Let Lopi, for example, that is more itchy, but it's not itchy at all. And I absolutely adore this color. It is green. It's not as bright as you can see it on the screen right now, but this is better, I think. It's a lovely color. My hair goes up. And I'm combining this with Ulrika Superwash. So this is the Superwash version. This is a brown color. Then I have Ulrika Nature. So again, non-superwash. This is a white. And I have something from my stash. Superwash Pure Merino DK by Signet Yarns in the color Denim. Now, on the screen you see very bright blue, and it's not bright at all. It's very matte. I think if I hold it up here, it's better. I love this color. So this is the combination for my no frill sweater, because I am combining this with the color charts of this cardigan. This is the Maya cardigan by Helena Magnusson, I think her name is. It's a free pattern on Etna, but I think it's only available in Dutch so far, and Swedish and Norwegian, I'm not sure. What I'm going to do is I am going to use this part and this part. As you can see, you see some blue in here, and that is my blue, that I will use the blue, my denim, and then the white, and green and brown. So I'm not going to knit this part. This is a cardigan that you knit in a round, and then you're going to steek it, so you will cut it open. I'm not going to do that. I'm just making the no frill sweater, and I'm adding this color work chart. My base color, main color, sorry, is the green one. And this is what I have so far. I'm currently working on the raglan sleeves, on the raglan increases. And I absolutely adore this color.
I hope you can see it like this. As I said, we have very weird light today. It's a lovely green color. I could knit my whole wardrobe with just this color. This is a lifeline, by the way, after the short rows. So this is the back. It's a very pretty color. It's a bit heathered, as you can see. Yeah, lovely color. Oops. So that is my plan. So I'm making the no frill sweater, and I will add a color work on the sleeves and on the bottom of the sweater. And at first I thought, oh, I don't have enough blue, but I weighed it, I had 35 grams, and then I checked the pattern and you only need, I think, 29 grams or so. Plus I don't knit the top with color work, so this will be enough. I think I'll have plenty of yarn. This is all I have left of this color. It was my favorite blue color by Pure Merino Superwash. Yeah, lovely color this is. And my plan was first to knit the color work with green, brown, and another color of brown and white. And I thought this will be a bit somber maybe. I thought I need a bit color in it. And then I chose the blue one. So, yeah, it's really nice. I'll show you the top of the cardigan. Focus. And there it comes. No, yeah. So I'm not going to knit this part. Yeah, now you can see it. But it really is lovely. That's the whole cardigan. Yeah, free pattern, so I can show you this. And I thought if I combine this with the no frills, that will make a lovely sweater, I hope. And yeah, this is all I have so far, part of the yoke. And then when I finish the yoke, I have to count the rows to see how big the color work will be. And then I can figure out when I have to start the color work. I don't want a very short or cropped sweater, I just want them. Maybe this size, like I'm now wearing it like this, but this is a very nice length, I think. Yeah, that's what I like. So that's my no frills Maya sweater, as I call it. But I'm not working on it at the moment because I have made a new list. That is something I told in my Dutch video at the end, because I forgot to tell them. At the end of last year, I made a list with all the projects I wanted to make, and it was a bit overwhelming because I had so many projects, and I thought, no, I'll make a new list. And that's what I did. This is my new list, because I'm also designing a new a shawl or a wrap for, and that will take a long time because a lot of work. And yeah, it's a big shawl or a big wrap. So I thought, what if I have just one project per month? And I thought, I just want to finish one thing per month. And if I finish it sooner, it's fine. And if it takes me longer, then that's fine too. So far, I finished my socks, my rib socks. That beanie is not on the list. That was just an in-between project. But I'm also working on my reference tee and the Felix cardigan. So the reference tee is a pattern by Hannah Lubin from Herb Garden Knitwear, and it is a test knit. And I thought, a test knit has a deadline and I just want to finish it way before the deadline. I like that. A little while ago I test knitted the Irene slipover from Rebecca by Journey Through Yarn, and I was so happy to finish it before the deadline. It gives me peace and quiet. It gives me, how do you say that, a good feeling to finish it on time. The Reverie's tee, the one I'm knitting now, it takes forever. That is how it feels, because I'm knitting this on a 3.5 millimeter needle. And I'm not used to do that. The pattern says 3 millimeter needle, but I already went up one size to 3.5. And it goes so slow because, yeah, 3.5 millimeter, I'm not used to it. I like to knit with chunky yarns or a DK weight or that kind of yarn. Now, but before I started to film this, I just put all my sweaters and cardigans on my big wooden box over here. It's a big wooden bookcase. And so, I'm getting there. It's getting much faster. It's getting better than I thought. So this is what I have so far. And I thought, that's not even that bad. It's because, I'll show you. This part, after I split for the sleeves, separate for the sleeves, this part, it took forever. And now I have double. And I thought, oh, it's not even that bad. So, this T has eyelets on every, how do you say it, on the cuff and the hem. You can't see them now, I think, because of the lifeline. Yeah. I always had a lifeline. And I made mistakes with these eyelets, but I don't care. I'll just leave them. They're eyelets, but I will do them better on the sleeves and on the hem over here. So this is what I have so far. I don't want it to be cropped. I think this length or maybe here, so that I can wear it on skirt. I don't like too cropped. That's just not my style, and I don't have a tummy for cropped shirts. There's a big advantage, there are short sleeves, so I'm getting, this will be finished in April, yeah. Absolutely, that's my goal. At first I thought, what if I knit the sleeves after I finished this ball of yarn? Because this is almost done. I thought, no, let's finish the body first. And it's not really tea weather at the moment over here. It's 10 degrees. I can see way at the back of the, we live outside, as we call it, in the countryside. And so I can see the sky. It's very dark over there, but the sun is shining. So I think we have some rainbows over here. Yeah, the weather is not suitable for this kind of tea, so I'm in no rush, but my deadline is half July, I think. It will be finished. I finished this in April. That's my goal, and I'm very determined to finish it. It's a lovely pattern, by the way. It is simple. The eyelets are the fun part, I think, as a nice touch, a nice detail for this tee. I will definitely will make this again, but without the eyelets. And then maybe with two colors or stripe, you know, striped, I don't know, maybe I'll even add a color chart in it, like what I'm doing with my no-frill sweater. We'll see, but this is not my, this won't be my only reverie tee, even though it goes very slow. But I think next time I will use another type of yarn, maybe a DK weight and a 4 millimeter needle or 4.5, I'm not sure yet. But so far, I really like it. It's dark blue, so dark blue goes with everything, I think. See a lot of hairs from the cat, from Sarah. Sarah is one of our cats, and for some reason she likes to sit on my lap lately. So when I'm sitting upstairs behind my desk, watching podcast and knitting this, I can do two things at the same time. She sits on my lap and begs for sweets, and yeah, but also a lot of cat hair. Oh, never mind, it is what it is. I like it. Yeah. So this is my reverie tee. First thing on my list to finish. I have as a goal April. And for May I have another project. And that is my Felix cardigan. Now of course if I finish this on time I will continue with this earlier. Last time I showed you my Felix cardigan and I wasn't happy with the sleeve at all. It was way too tight. Some people gave me advice and they said your sleeve is too tight, you should unravel it or do something to this or do that, and yeah, I listened to that. This is not too tight, the armhole is not too tight, really it's not, it's fine. But the sleeve itself didn't feel comfortable, so I frogged the whole sleeve. And for the fourth time, I'm knitting on a sleeve. The pattern says that I need 48 stitches for the sleeve, and this time I added some stitches and I'm now working on 56 stitches. And that makes all the difference. Just a couple of extra stitches and it's fine now, because I like to wear cardigans over blouses or tops with long sleeves and blouse, so you have already two extra layers under your sleeve. What did I do? As I said, I casted on extra stitches and I started to decrease when I was about here, so halfway my underarm. I have decreased two times so far. I think I will have to decrease one more time and then I can start with the cuff. And I will make a rather long cuff, longer than this one. This one is rather short, as you can see. I want a bit, that's all. I want a longer cuff, and because I like that. And I'm not sure yet if I want to make this a long cardigan or a short one. At first I said I want to make it longer, and then I thought, maybe a short one is also nice, that comes to the hips, for example. But I also like cardigans that go that are long enough to reach above the knee. I just like long cardigans, especially in the winter. And next time I'll do something also different. I think I already mentioned that last. I'm now knitting this on a 5.5 millimeter needle. I started with a 6, that was way too big. After a couple of rows, I changed to the 5.5 millimeter. And I think next time, if I use Let Lopi again, because this is Let Lopi yarn, I will use 5 millimeter or 4.5 millimeter. I think 4.5, because it's very loose, but I think a 4.5 would be better. I forgot to show you the yarn, I think. This is Let Lopi in the color celery green, yeah. It's very difficult to pronounce for a Dutch person. Well, for me it is. This is suitable for 4 and 5 millimeter. So, as you can see. Can you see that with the light? Oh, yeah. But I think 4.5 will be better next time. Love this color, love this yarn. It is a bit scratchy, a bit itchy. It doesn't bother me at all. The Ulrika Nature is softer than this one. And like what I did in the Dutch video, I will do now also. I will compare the two colors. Now, green is my favorite color. This looks a bit bright, but it's not bright at all. Really, it's not. And this looks a bit more rustic. But they're both beautiful colors. Yeah, let me see if I can change the light a bit. Oh. Oops. Yeah, it all happens when you podcast. Nope. Well, yeah, I think this is better. Nope. This is better, I think. Yeah. Much better. Oh, yes, much better. This is more the real color, what I now see. But I really love this color, the Ulrika one. So this is my Felix cardigan, a lovely pattern by Amy Christophers by Savory Knitting. I forgot to say that, I think. You can find all the details, by the way, below this video and on my Ravelry page. Very happy with this. It's a rather quick knit. If I hadn't started this sleeve three times, well, four times now, I would have finished it by now, I think, yeah. Because you just, it's just knit, purl, and yeah. I love to knit sleeves because they go very fast, if you don't make mistakes. And yeah, it's, I'm not finished yet, by the way. I still have to do the button bands, of course. I haven't thought about that yet. I've never done that, so that will be a whole new experience. But you learn something new every day. And there's no rush, but I like this project. So this will be my May project. Is that true, what I say, in May? Yeah. And the no frill sweater will be in June. Yeah. I'm just checking my list. I have bought something new, a little while ago, last week, Jennifer Steingass has her patterns for sale, 50% off. Every day she had another pattern for sale. And I thought, well, I do have a couple of her patterns, and with mixed feelings. I love them, they're very pretty, her sweaters. I made a sea change sweater. I wear it a lot, but I changed the cuff because it bothered me, but I get more experience in knitting and I don't know how to fix that or how to do short rows, so I thought I'm going to buy one of her patterns that was on sale, and it's a very popular one. It's called the Avena sweater. I love this. I'm in no rush to make this sweater. I think it's a beautiful pattern. I've noticed also that this pattern, that the, how do you call the ferns, are darker and then go lighter. I think I will make this in one color. And I think I will make this sweater with Let Lobe, because I still have plenty of Let Lobe in my stash, and I have gray Let Lobe. That would be really nice, I think. And I have a couple of colors I can use for the ferns. I call them ferns, but I'm not sure if this is a fern, but it looks like a fern to me. Maybe she writes about that. Let me see. No. No. But this is on my to-do list. It's not even on my big list yet, but no rush. And I really love this pattern. And I'm glad I bought it now. And it was 50% cheaper. That's another rule I have. I'm only allowed to buy patterns if they're on sale, because I have a budget. In the beginning of the year I said I'm not going to buy any patterns this year. Well, so far I have already bought 7, so there goes my goal. Yeah, it is what it is, and I've bought patterns that I will maybe knit twice, so who knows. If I talk about the no frill sweater, I already made one and I'm making it again, so that's a good buy, I think. Did I forget anything? I have a feeling I'm going so fast through my list today. Right, I was going to tell you about our day out. If you have ever been to the Netherlands, you might have been to 's-Hertogenbosch. That's the long name. The short name is Den Bosch. And I'm not going to tell you why that is, or I'm not an historian. But it's a lovely old city. I've lived there for a while, years ago. It has changed, but I still know my way around. And his company, my boyfriend's company, had a day out there on Saturday. It was Saturday a week ago. And it was the day that it was 25 degrees in the Netherlands. First hot day here, a warm day. So we were very lucky with the weather. First we went to a cafe where we bought a bossenbol. A bossenbol is like a profiterole covered with chocolate, and inside it had whipped cream. And they're huge. and with a lot of calories, and I thought I'm not gonna eat that one today because I want to lose some weight. And I already checked the internet and I saw one of these have 550 calories in it. That's a lot. That's a complete meal. But I just put it in front of me and they put it in front on the table and I couldn't resist. I know I'm weak, but I didn't eat the last 100 calories, so I didn't finish it. Then we were split in two groups after the coffee with the Bossenbol, and we went to visit the St. Jan Cathedral. A beautiful, beautiful cathedral if you ever go there to Den Bosch, visit the cathedral. And we could go up into the tower and to have a great view over the city. Now there's one problem, I'm claustrophobic. A lot, very much. Don't lock me up because I'll panic. And the tour guy said, well, the last one has to close the door, has to lock the door so that other people won't come in. And I said, oh, I don't like to be locked up. And I already checked the stairs. The staircase is very narrow. Well, if you've ever been in the church tower, then you know how that looks. And I said to my boyfriend, it's not going to happen. I'm not going up. I'm not afraid of heights, no problem at all. But if I'm in a very narrow staircase and I can't escape, that's the feeling I have to. I must know that I can escape. And the door is locked. I said, I'm not going to do that. No, I'll just go shopping. Let me go shopping. I mean, I live in a village. We have one small supermarket here. I'm not a big fan of shopping, but now, every now and then, when I'm in a city, I just love to shop or just to look. So that's what I did. I did film the cathedral, and I did go into the cathedral itself, but not into the tower. And I filmed that as well. So I went shopping at Dille en Camille and Sustrene Grene. Sustrene Grene is, I think, a Danish shop? Danish or Swedish? I think Danish. And they have the most lovely things. And same goes for Dille en Camille. And Dille en Camille means in English, I think, dill and chamomile. I think. Beautiful stuff they have, so much nice things. And I saw the most beautiful mugs and I thought, no, I can't buy them. I have plenty of mugs. I just couldn't do it. I wanted, but I didn't do it. I did buy a couple of things like stuff for the kitchen and anti-moth blocks, wooden things with a cedar. It's called cedar wood, I think it is. With a special smell that moths don't like. And I bought some oils like lavender oil and cedar oil and stuff like that. And then we had lunch. Lunch was crap. Really, I'm not even going to talk about it. It was really bad. And after lunch, we went for a boat tour on the Binnendiezen. That's really lovely because you sail on that small canal. I think it's a canal. And yeah, it's beautiful. It's really something. You sail under the houses sometimes. And after that, we ate again because we had dinner. And they had great cake. The cake was amazing. I had a vegetarian dish because I don't eat meat, and I had something with pumpkin, I think it was. It was lovely. So yeah, that was our day out. And if you're curious about that, then have a look. And if not, then it's starting to rain again. I don't know if you can hear that on the roof. Yeah, that's it, what I have to tell you today. I do have some other news, but I will save that for next time or the day or the time after that. But yeah, maybe next time I can tell you more about that. Anyway, thank you for watching again. I hope you have a nice day, a lovely week, and hope to see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Dus dat trok het publiek aan. Het stadje groeide als kool. Maar ja, er kwamen de Hollanders, die waren jaloers op ons succes. En die gingen door plunderen en platbranden. Dat waren voornamelijk de Leuzenaren, dat wij concurreerden dat vestingstadje kapot namelijk. Gelukkig is dat allemaal goed gekomen, we hebben gesloten, dus het is allemaal weer goed gekomen. En men, de hertog van Brabant, hertog is eigenlijk afgeleid van heer of tsoe, oftewel legerleiding. Dus een hertog is eigenlijk met zijn hertogdom, die verdedigt dus dat gebied met naam van de koning of de keizer. Dus waar we straks langs nog waren. Maar het stadje groeide als kool en men begon buiten de stadsmuren te bouwen. De Sint-Jan werd ook buiten de stadsmuren gebouwd. Niet veilig, niet slim vanwege de hoogwater en de plunderaars. Dus men vroeg op een gegeven moment aan de hertog mogen de stad. Het was niet veilig vanwege het hoogwater en allerlei plunderaars. En alle waterwegen binnen die stadsmuren werd toen binnentriezen genoemd. Maar ja, door ruimtegebrek, wij deden de bossen daar, maar dat ruimtegebrek op de vangst. Dat zien we altijd op het eind. Over.
Ja?
Ja, we hebben enig idee waar we zijn.
Gemeentehuis.
Waar?
Nee, ik weet het niet. Het gemeentehuis.
Nee.
Oh, dat komt
nog. Vugtestraat zijn we.
Oh, ja.
Nou hier, daar rechts van ons, dat is de Parkstroom, is opengemaakt door de gemeente, althans een stukje om, ja, een beetje de illusie, puur toeristische ideeën. Want vroeger was de binnendienst bijna 70 kilometer lang. Daar is slechts 3,6 kilometer van over. Goochelaar heeft een oud in zijn mandje samen met het balletje. En ligt hij het publiek op. Dat gebeurt nog steeds met balletje.
Ja.
En zakkenrollers die konden de slag slaan. En het heeft de gemeente een mooie doorgang gemaakt. En dat is in 1995. Met die kathedraal van de gemeente. Boven in de guillotine.
Pas op.
Nu de mede.
Ik vertelde
nooit thuis.
Deze muur is niet zo dik en de tijd van pijn omhoog, maar wel heel hard. Dus we gaan even extra op de hoogte schouwen. Dus we moeten alles goed een beetje van. Ik ga naar links uitwijken. Binnen, aan de andere kant van de bos, van A naar binnen. En zo doet de bom alles tegengehouden worden. bouw vandaag en dat wil toch die stad blijven stromen. Duitse Tel is niet altijd een museum geweest. Is altijd een groot klooster geweest van de Bogarden. Bij de inname van...